So I'm Yukino from Kyoto University. Today I'm going to report a feasibility study on predictive approaches for supporting preventive medicine in Bangladesh. So this work is done by a big team, including machine learning people and medical doctors and people in grameen communications. This is a non-profit company in Bangladesh. So I first show the highlights of this study. We conducted 2-year-long field study in Bangladesh and collected the health checkup results of 15,000 subjects in Bangladesh. We applied predictive approaches to the collected data set and obtained two remarkable results. First, we contribute to reducing the health checkup cost. Our method successfully reduced the cost by 50% if it is allowed to have a 1% chance of false negative cases. Second, we reduce the follow-up checkup cost. Follow-up checkup is the process to discover subjects who are still at the high risk 1 year after the first health checkup. Our method covers 67% of high-risk subjects when we are allowed to allocate only 40% of the total budget. So I start by introducing the data collection procedure. We developed Portable Health Clinic System, or PHC in short. PHC is an efficient and easy to operate preventive medicine service using information and communication technologies. PHC is composed of portable package for health checkups. The woman in this picture has a suitcase, and this suitcase is equipped with a tablet and consumable goods for health checkup. We also prepared a teleconsultation service using Skype over our mobile network. The woman in this picture is a medical doctor, and she is consulting with a subject using Skype. We conducted a PhD field study in Bangladesh. In this field study, the subjects were first asked to complete a questionnaire, and then they underwent the checkup. The result of the checkup is what's stored in a tablet and sent to the server at the telemedical center. Using the checkup result, we categorize the subject into low risk or high risk. And for the subjects in the high risk group, we provide teleconsultation service with doctors at the telemedical center. In addition, 1 year later, we provided follow-up checkup to the subject. So PHC has been established as a beneficial and efficient preventive medicine service, but there is still a room for improvement to make it a cost-efficient system. In fact, cost is one of the critical issues which affecting popularization of such programs in developing countries. So in this study, we apply predictive approaches to our collected data set and investigate the usage of machine learning methods for providing a low-cost preventive medicine service. We address two prediction problems. One is the subject risk prediction for checkup cost reduction, and the other is future risk prediction for efficient follow-up process. I'll explain them one by one. The first part is about subject risk prediction. So goal of health checkup is to determine the risk level of subject. This slide shows the rule we used in this study to assign risk level to each subject. So when a subject takes a checkup, our criterion assigns healthy, caution, affected, or emergency to the result of each of 12 checkup items. For example, the subject whose result is shown in this table is assigned with healthy in his waist measurement and is assigned with caution in his pulse rate measurement. And using the result, a subject is categorized as low risk if the subject is assigned with healthy or caution in all the checkup items. Otherwise, the subject is assigned at high risk. So for example, the subject of this table is categorized as high risk because he has an affected label in his arrhythmia. And our health checkup procedure in PHC includes low-cost test and high-cost test. High-cost tests such as urine tests and blood sugar tests that require consumable goods for doing checkup. Such high-cost tests make the health checkup expensive. So we want to save the money. We can save the cost if we skip high-cost tests and predict the risk level from the rest of tests. We formalize this risk prediction problem. The goal of this problem is to predict risk level for all the subjects with low checkup costs. We assume that each subject will take a checkup in sequence, and each subject take each checkup items in a fixed order. So for example, in this picture, all the subjects start from a BMI measurement, continue with waist measurement, and so on. We assume that we can control when to stop checkup for each subject. For example, the subject in the right side, a procedure for this subject will stop at the 11th checkup item and skips the last one. After each subject takes the health checkup, our prediction system outputs the risk level of the subject. And there is one constraint, practical constraint, that the subjects who are predicted as high risk are required to take all the tests because we use the results in the teleconsultation step. A naive strategy for solving this problem is to skip all high-cost tests and predict risk levels from the result of the low-cost test. This strategy uses a single classifier. To train the classifier, we first offer all the tests to the first N subject and obtain ground truth. And the rest of subjects only offers the low-cost test, and their risk levels are predicted from the result of the low-cost test. So this single classifier strategy drastically cuts the health checkup cost. But we can use more careful strategy to avoid the false negative cases. The strategy we prepared for this purpose is called multiple classifier strategy. The procedure of this strategy is very simple. If a classifier predicts a subject at high risk, this strategy offer the next high-cost test to the subject. So here are two examples. In the first case, when the subject takes the low-cost test, a classifier predicts the subject at low risk. So the process for this subject will be terminated because the system considers that we do not need to spend money on this subject. In the second case, from the result of the low cost, the classifier predicts the subject at high risk. In this case, the subject will be offered the next high cost test because this system considers that it will be valuable to spend money to investigate this subject. And using the result of the low cost test and one high cost test, another classifier predicts the risk level of this subject. If the second classifier predicts the subject as low risk, the process will be terminated. And if the classifier predicts the subject as high risk at this point, the next high cost test will be offered. So this multiple classifier strategy is quite simple, but very useful to reduce the checkup cost. We applied the both strategies to the collected data set in Bangladesh and evaluated the balance between the cost rate and false negative rate. False negative is a case where a high-risk subject is wrongly identified as low-risk. And we observed that our multiple classifier strategy successfully reduced the cost by 50% with only 1% of false negative case. Considering the fact that we need at least 34% of cost to offer the high cost test to the subjects who are actually at high risk, we can conclude that our multiple classifier strategy demonstrated a remarkable performance.
Had such a serious disease, then 1% is very bad.
Yeah, so
you could have done 100% reduction with 1%.
So the target subject are ordinary people. I mean that our health checkups are offered to the ordinary people. So how would I say? Yeah, portion of all the high-risk subjects. So.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Thanks. Yeah. So I'll move to the second part. The second part is about future risk prediction for efficient follow-up process. Follow-up process aims to take care of subjects who are at high risk in the second year. This process first conducts a follow-up checkup to examine the current risk level of subject, and then provides follow-up action for the subject who are turned out to be at high risk. If a budget for the follow-up checkup is limited, we should set the priority to the subject. So there are two cases. So the left case is that we should put high priority because we should take and follow-up action to the subjects who are turned out to be at high risk. In contrast, the right case is the one we should put low priority, because when it is turned out that the subject is low risk, we do not take any action. So we should put the priority to the subjects who are likely to be at high risk. We determine the priority of the priority by predicting the risk level in the second year from the checkup results of the first year. So we formalize the follow-up priority detection problem. The goal of this problem is to determine the follow-up priority under a budget constraint. We assume that we are given the result we are given the checkup result of the first year and the budget constraint. We wish to determine the priority so that we can examine as many of the high-risk subjects as possible. A straightforward strategy is to put priority to the subjects who are likely to be at high risk. This strategy first offers follow-up checkups to a small number of subjects and obtain ground truth and train an initial classifier. Then, for each step, this strategy selects the subject who is the most likely to be at high risk. The result of the first year is given as the subject feature vector, and the classifier predicts the predicts the probability of subjects being at high risk. This process is called exploitation. And the selected subject is offered the follow-up checkup, and we use the output to the update the classifier. If we have a well-trained classification, a classifier, and if we have a good classifier, the exploitation on this strategy may work efficiently. However, because of the budget constraint, we resort to have a classifier trained with a small number of samples and iteratively update the classifier. So choosing the high-risk subjects is not always a good strategy for improving the classifier because it tends to collect similar samples. A reasonable solution is to select subjects who are informative to improve the classifier. We call this strategy exploration and exploitation strategy. In each step, our strategy selects the subjects who are the most informative to update the classifier with probability of epsilon. We consider that a subject with the least certainty of being at high risk is the most informative one. Such notion is used in active learning. We compare the proposed strategy with the original follow-up procedure in terms of the coverage rate under a budget constraint. And our exploration and exploitation strategy showed the better performance than the original procedure. For example, when the budget constraint is 40%, the actual coverage rate is 46%, while ours covered 67%. And also, our strategy shows better performance than the exploitation on this strategy, so we can conclude that the collecting informative samples is important for solving this problem. So that's also, we have reported our feasibility study to apply predictive modeling approaches to support preventive medicine in Bangladesh. So I'm happy to take some questions.
Thompson sampling or
those? We didn't that. So, yeah, so I think that there will be some variation on this part.
Yeah, but
we only apply this one. We should do that. We should compare that. Yeah, thank you.
For the first part of your work, would be ordering of tests?
Sorry? Mm-hmm.
For the first part of your work, mm-hmm. could a different ordering of medical tests affecting, did you explore that? Because instead of only low cost, I mean, maybe there's another slightly higher cost, but if it's more discriminative in terms of letting you distinguish between low risk and high risk,
that
may be better.
So
did you explore different orders?
We didn't do that. We fixed the order because it is practical constraint, we think, because the unskilled the healthcare workers do not handle such situations. So, yeah. Thanks so much.
Thank your speaker again.
Yes.